don't be so hesitant to reach out to somebody, because remember, you want to and need to expand your horizons.
And this is also another reason why I definitely chose you guys, because I know you guys are like the young guns in this war.
The whole idea of guilds, you know, in the medieval ages comes from mentorship and apprenticeship. And I think it's an idea that's kind of been around humans for a long time, and it works.
We talk a lot about, you know, Michael Jordan had a coach, Kanye had a mentor, and Jay-Z, you know, everyone that's done anything great has had a mentor.
Having a mentor has changed and enhanced my life in a lot of ways. I've been able to see and know and acknowledge that I'm being mentored. Sometimes you're shy about it, you don't want it, but then you have to step up to it and say, wow, I'm being mentored by this person who I admire.
Anybody who mentors a young person or volunteers time will always tell you that they get so much more out of it than they give.
I know that this happened to me for a reason. I never questioned it. I know that this is why God did this to me. And it was for me to prove a point. I was injured January 2nd, 1988. I was in the ocean in the Caribbean on vacation, and the wave flipped me over, my head hit the ocean floor, and I broke C5 and C6 in my neck. And I became a quadriplegic immediately.
As a person who's not, academically successful, but feel like I do have a lot of passion, I felt like this was exactly what I needed.
I had all this, like, inspiration. I didn't know what to do with it. I was, like, gonna go crazy if I didn't do something.
I used to love school, and I don't love it anymore. Mainly because I feel very constricted, I guess. I don't think that I can express myself in the ways that I would.
Some of the words I would use to describe some people who I mentor are, they could be scared, nervous, lost.
The most helpful thing that Alan does is just the fact that he's there for you no matter what. He knows a lot more than you do. He's had a lot more experience. If you have a question about your body, your physicality, your chairs, anything you need or anything that you're confused about, he's there to help.
When I met Tyler, I totally understood the situation, and it was more like I saw something in Tyler that maybe he hadn't seen in himself, but I saw something in him, just the way in the way he approached me, that I know he could go far, and that it was a disservice for him not to have any access to his mentor.
Prior to coming into the JWT, they had assigned me a mentor. But up until that point, you know, I hadn't had any contact with this person. So when I got talking to Kenny about, you know, like, oh, I requested you to be my mentor, but I found out it wasn't like a request thing, and they assigned you mentors, and he told me, all right, whoever your mentor is, tell that person that I'm your mentor now.
Since meeting Andy through Torch, one thing I've learned is the true meaning of perseverance. Because if you looked at Andy on paper, didn't know what he looked like, but you saw where he came from and the things that led up to who he was at that point when I met him, you may have thought or assumed there may have been a different path for him. But to eke out an existence based in creativity in a time where there weren't a lot of opportunities for people of color, and to become an art director from the South Bronx, to me, is, if you looked up in the dictionary, there literally would be a picture of his face under perseverance and determination.
Being a kid from the Bronx, it's a jungle. You know, you get down into the city and it's it can be overwhelming.
My feeling when I first walked into a meeting with Torch, my first mentoring experience was like, wow, like, what am I doing here? Do I fit in here? It was just really amazing to be a part of this world that I had never seen before. It seemed cool and new.
I first heard about the Future Project the first or second week of school. To be honest, it was a little bit ambiguous, but I think that was part of the reason that I joined the Future Project, is that there is this part that I wanted to find out what it was, and the only way to find out what it was was to join.
I applied to work at the Film Fund. Terry Lawler was executive director. I was in college, and I got accepted to the work study program.
My name is Tim, and I am the Dream Director at the Lab School, and I work for the Future Project.
My name is John Michael Parker, and I'm a Dream Director with the Future Project at Richard R. Green High School. A Dream Director is somebody who comes into a school and helps the young people here find their passions and their dreams and chase those and build projects out of them that show them that they have the power to change the world and to live the life, a life they could only have imagined.
Basically, what we're doing at the Future Project is we want high school to be a place where you walk in, declare what you're passionate about, declare what your dreams are, and you spend your time at high school making that happen. You learn, you teach, you mentor each other, you mentor up, you mentor down. You do all that in an effort to pursue your passion, your dream, because then you're suddenly in school because you want it. We have a group of 40 to 60 students at every school we're at who are building projects of their own that put their passions and dreams into action. And for every one of those fellows, we're finding coaches who share that same passion and want to help them make that happen.
The peer mentoring program at the Pittsburgh Data Reef Foundation is something that is funded by the federal government. And the way that it works is people call into the Paralysis Resource Center, and that's where it's basically like the hub for the spinal cord community and paralysis world, where people call when they're looking for information. We give out free resource guides. There's plenty of information on our website as to where to go. And when people come into our resource center, the first thing we try to do is hook them up with a peer mentor.
I think mentoring and the way I describe the Torch program often is that we do this. And it's our job to sort of show young people what's out there, what the possibilities are.
Sammy was talking about Torch and about how it was changing his life. He talked about it all the time.
I was really interested about my mentor because it's set up to be an online base. So once a week, they have prompts that you write with your mentee back and forth, and that's part of their school assignment.
What we try to do through the mentoring program is find a, let's just say it's a Hispanic 26-year-old female. We're going to try to find somebody Hispanic in their 20s female that she can relate to.
iMentor uses the same type of software that you would find in a dating service. So it's obviously not the same types of questions, but the technology behind it is the same. So you fill out a questionnaire online and they use it to match you with a student.
So we link people according to what they're passionate about, from all different backgrounds, from all different places, from different genders, different, you know, sexuality, you know, whatever. And we're going to link you according to what you're passionate about, because we think one of the biggest things you can connect over in the world is what you're passionate about, what your dream is.
I think being a mentor should be a part of anybody's day. And it's not even about mentoring most of the time. Sometimes we're just cracking jokes, you know, just brightening each other's day. But I mean, I've had a mentee, you know, text me and say, Kenny, I'm about to quit my job. I can't deal. And then that's when you go into like, let's meet this evening. Let's talk.
Everybody that I talk to, I catch them in different phases. Some of them are injured a day or two or a week, some a month, some a year, some years.
Coaching at its most basic means having someone or being for someone a stand for possibility.
I love my coach. My coach is actually my favorite person in the whole world. Most of the things we do are sit around and drink coffee because his favorite beverage is coffee and my favorite beverage is coffee. And we just sit around and drink coffee and talk about everything that's not the Future Project. And then I'm like, oh, I have to go. And he's like, oh, whoops, because then we didn't talk about anything Future Project related. But we talk about my life. And he helped me work through my problems. And he is a coach and a life friend, because I won't let him get out of contact with me.
At the start of the program, you know, in November when we meet, I mean, 10 to 15 students. And most everybody's pretty quiet and doesn't have much to say. And what I find really exciting and interesting is that by the end of this school year, everybody's talking, everybody's vibrant, everybody's vocal, everybody has learned something. And maybe we don't all learn how to make a film, we learn how to communicate and to talk and to share and to express ourselves.
Mentoring helped me learn the process of making a documentary technically, but also the different skills you need to brainstorm and work with your peers, because when you're working alone, you can get trapped in like a path. And when you get to work with others and mentor, you know, from someone who's older than you or someone who's your same age, you bounce your ideas off each other and you end up with a more diverse and dynamic project.
There's just such a beautiful circle of
inspiration that happens, I think, between mentors and mentees. And I am grateful and so lucky to have experienced that.
Mentoring means really taking an interest in a young person and being able to see that that person has unlimited potential, and knowing that you, as a person who's been involved in whatever industry you're working in or whatever field you're working in, that you have something to offer that person and that you can pass on your expertise to them and see them go on and do great things too. I think to me, mentoring means being able to connect to who you're mentoring in a very direct way, in a very positive way. It's just about being able to connect and seeing that the mentor was once in the mentee's shoes.
In high school, having Torch as my base and moving on to college, I was in Posse and we had mentors. Moving to Nielsen, my first job out of college, we had a formal mentorship in place where I worked with senior leaders to better understand the business and my role.
I don't set goals because of having a mentor, but I reach my goals oftentimes because my mentor is around.
There was a young boy from Westchester, Luke, who goes to Vanderbilt University, who dove off of a boat and his head hit the ocean, hit the floor, and his neck snapped. And he has, it was all fraternity brothers. And I got three phone calls within 20 minutes from different parents of the kids that are in fraternity. Alan, what do we do? What do we do? What do we do? These are all kids that thought they were invincible, and they didn't know what to do. And I got all of them onto a call, and we spent 2 hours on the phone.
Definitely wasn't a, hey, let me make a phone call, let me Skype with you guys and bounce kind of guy. I mean, he was there saying, hey, this is what happened. Here's what's going on. I'm going to be there for you. Here's my cell phone. Call me at my house. You call me whenever. I'm here for you. And let me help you guys.
We took care of Luke, who's doing unbelievably. His strength and his comeback has been great. And I remember going to see him in the hospital for the first time. Seeing a lot of myself and knowing what it was like to have your whole life in front of you at that young age. And then he sees me being the old man at 45 years old, being through this for a long time. And I saw his eyes light up, and I knew that I gave him hope.
If you're newly in the chair and you think, like, down the line, oh, this is going to be terrible, this sucks, and you see him having a great time, you're like, okay, this is fine. Like, I'm going to have a good time too. Think of it as a pyramid. He knows so much, and he's so experienced, and so when he helps other people, they help other people in turn, and so it just like spreads to a whole like bunch of people, and it's just unbelievable what he does.
Caring isn't a 9-to-5 thing. You either care or you don't. And so with someone like Alan, he doesn't care whether it's 9:30 at night and he's at his house in Miami and you need him, or whether it's while he's at the office. If you need him, you need him. And I think that that's a quality that my dad's taught me, and I hope to have one day as a father and as a mentor.
Being a mentor is probably one of the most important things, because at some point when you look back at your life, someone helped you.
My favorite thing to say is, reaching back has never held me back, it's held others up. I don't feel like mentoring, I never get tired of it, because it doesn't feel like, you know, work. It feels like just a natural extension of who I am.
Being a mentor and knowing the influence you have on someone really makes you step up your own game.
Sometimes I'll just send my mentees a picture, and I'll say, think about this today. And that's mentoring right there. I don't have to see you, but I'm thinking about you guys.